camel driver. Where is he?
He left the tavern about an hour ago.
Oh, quick, which way did he go?
He took the south road.
Thanks, Sonny.
Are you the driver who got a lamp from the tavern keeper's son?
I am. What's amiss, friend? It was a fair bargain.
Yes, yes, we know. We just want to buy the lamp from you. Name your price.
Name the price? For that old lamp?
Well, you don't understand. It's a family heirloom, which means much to us.
Yes, you see, our grandmother used to place it in the window to help grandfather find his way home every night.
Oh, your grandfather, he was blind?
6 nights out of 7.
You touch me very deeply, friends. It would give me great pleasure to return it to you.
The pleasure would be ours.
I know how it is. Am I not a sentimental man myself?
Oh, I'm sure you are.
I had a grandmother myself. A fine woman.
I'm sure she was. Now, about the lamp.
When I was a small child, she used to hold me on her knee and bathe me with scented oils and perfumes.
You haven't seen your grandmother lately, have you?
My grandmother was a beautiful woman. She had a wonderful voice. Every night she would sing me to sleep with her sweet, soft, soothing voice.
I don't like my grandmother's voice.
Again.
I see what you mean. So we'll give you 5 dinars and be on our way.
That is a very handsome sum, Effendi, but I could not dream of taking so much for it.
All right, we'll give you 3 dinars.
Oh, no. I would much prefer to return it to you for nothing. As I said, am I not a
very
sentimental man myself?
Yes, yes.
As you will, but hurry.
Hurry?
Hurry up and give us the lamp.
I would be honored to do so, my friends.
Yes, you've already said that.
But you see, I don't have it now.
You what?
I don't have it now. Half an hour ago, on this very road, I met Ali the tailor, a fine man.
Yes.
You should know him.
I know too many people now.
He was on his way back to the city. And after some bargaining, I traded the lamp for a new sash.
Ali the tailor, where did you say he lives?
He lives, let me see now. I just don't seem to recall at the present time, but you'll have no trouble finding him. Everyone in the marketplace knows of Ali the tailor.
The marketplace.
Thanks a lot.
Master, that I am the slave of the lamp of Nador.
Help! Help!
Relax, will you? I'm yours to command in all things, be they great or small. Ask and it shall be given you. Command and it shall be done.
Hello, Priscilla.
Oh, gosh, I sure picked the weirdest characters.
Go away. Please go away.
Oh, take it easy, buddy. I didn't choose you for a master. In fact, you're something that shouldn't even happen to a genie.
A genie? Oh, welcome. Welcome, miraculous one. What can I do for you?
No, you got it backwards. What can I do for you? All you have to do is name it.
You mean I ask for something and it comes to pass?
Sure. Anything you want?
By the bones of Mastaba. Whatever will they think of next? Well, let me see. There is something I have long desired.
Okay, it's all yours.
Well, I would like...
Well, tell me, what is it?
Well...
Oh, you can tell me.
Well, I would like a red-headed seamstress. In fact, I would like several.
Redheads, huh?
Well, this kind.
Coming up. Hold on to your top knot.
Miss Rose? Do you mean that...
Oh.
Do you mean they're all mine?
And they can cook, too.
Oh, that's wonderful. I just love good cooking.
Is there anything else that I can do for you?
No. Yes, there is. Like all good tailors, I have a passion for beautiful clothes. Could you bring me the most priceless garment in all the land? One studded with jewels and gold braid and... In fact, I'd like the very robe worn by the Sultan himself.
The Sultan's not gonna like this, but orders are orders.
May your wedded life be one of constant joy. And now it is hereby proclaimed...
Highness.
What is the meaning of this disturbance? How dare you interrupt the ceremony?
My lord, look. Look.
I'll have the scoundrel fit who played this trick. The ceremony will continue when I return.
Why did you leave the ceremony, my dear?
Where's my father?
Your father? Why, your father went to his chambers.
That was my uncle, Prince Haji.
Why, child, your uncle is in exile.
My uncle is here in the palace, masquerading as the Sultan.
Amina, the excitement of the wedding has been too much for you.
Prince Haji's attempt on my father's life left him with an ugly scar on his arm. That man had no such wound.
Well, if this is so, we must proceed with caution.
Caution? There's no time for that. We must learn what happened to my father.
Oh, yes, yes, of course.
The emirs and chamberlains are still assembled. If you do not denounce the impostor to them, I will.
I shall do so at once. Wait here. You said nothing could go wrong.
Wrong? What are you talking about?
The princess knows you are not the Sultan.
Don't be a fool. How could she?
By the long scar on her father's arm.
I forgot about that.
But the princess didn't.
Where is she now?
Locked in her chambers.
Nothing has gone wrong yet.
What are you going to do?
I'm sure you will mourn her with becoming grief.
What? Ali the tailor. This must be it.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Customers, I'm afraid you're too late. Ali the tailor has retired from business.
Say, pal, that's really a sharp robe you got there. You know I've been looking for one just like it? Yeah, man, it's really solid. And those shoulders, zoot! Where do you begin? Oh, and the sleeves, are they loose enough? Don't you think sleeves should be loose? I mean, if they're loose, it gets you a chance to get in there, be on a beam, you know what I mean? Be hip. Yeah, you really look fine. Where did you get it, pal?
Well, Effendi,